Alpha-GPC and Ginkgo, could they hurt your sleep? Hi, I'm Dr. Chris Masterjohn of ChrisMasterjohnPhD.com, and this is Chris Masterjohn Lite, where the name of the game is details, schmeetails, just tell me what works. And today we're going to talk about the Alpha-GPC and Ginkgo cocktail from the last episode that I talked about using for focused concentration, whether taking that at night could hurt your sleep. So here's the deal. Acetylcholine is great for focused concentration. But when you sleep, acetylcholine's got to basically drop to zero to get deep sleep. And you do have a boost of acetylcholine activity during REM sleep, which is associated with dreaming, but you don't have as much acetylcholine even then than you would when you're awake. So most of the time when you're not in REM sleep, you really want low acetylcholine levels. Now, there is a study that I found that taking acetylcholinesterase inhibitors for Alzheimer's results in less sleeping problems when people take them in the morning and don't take them at night. And I think that does support the idea that the acetylcholinesterase inhibitors could interfere with your ability to get into deep sleep when acetylcholine levels are supposed to go down practically to zero. So that makes me skeptical that we should be dealing with the Ginkgo, at least the Ginkgo, maybe even the Alpha-GPC, which both boost acetylcholine levels, whether we should be dealing with those at night. What I do is I take them in the morning and the afternoon. I generally don't even take them in the late afternoon because I don't need to. Once I get two doses of that cocktail in, I get a lot of focused concentration that can just whoosh, keep going through the day. And even though they take 1,200 milligrams of Alpha-GPC in the Alzheimer's studies, I have never gone above 600 milligrams because I just haven't needed it. So I don't have any experience with that, but my guess would be it's okay to take the Alpha-GPC at night, but not the Ginkgo, because the Alpha-GPC just allows you to make acetylcholine. The Ginkgo's there to keep it there longer. It prevents it from being broken down. And my suspicion, my guess, is that when you transfer between REM sleep, which has a significant acetylcholine stimulation to it, when you transfer from that to deep sleep, you need to get rid of the acetylcholine pretty fast, and you depend on acetylcholinesterase to make that happen. And so the Ginkgo with its acetylcholinesterase inhibition could interfere with that. On the other hand, maybe you could make an argument that you want the Alpha-GPC in order to get into REM sleep. So perhaps, let's say you're tracking your sleep with an Oura ring, and you find that you're getting the deep sleep that you need, but consistently your REM sleep is low. REM sleep plays an important role in dreaming, in memory consolidation, in learning and creativity. So it makes sense that you want to get enough of it. So if the Oura ring is telling you you're not getting enough REM sleep, then I would say maybe try taking the Alpha-GPC at night. You could experiment with the Ginkgo, but I suspect it's going to hurt your deep sleep. But then again, if you're tracking with the Oura ring, you should be able to determine in an experimental in a very rigorous experiment, what happens when I take Alpha-GPC before bed? What happens when I take Ginkgo before bed? My suspicion, again, is the Alpha-GPC could boost your REM sleep, but you don't want to go with the Ginkgo because it could hurt your deep sleep. With that said, if you're out there tracking these things, definitely let me know in the comments what you're finding.
This episode is brought to you by Ancestral Supplements Grass-Fed Beef Brain. Our Native American ancestors believed that eating the organs from a healthy animal would support the health of the corresponding organ of the individual. Ancestral Supplements has a nose-to-tail product line of grass-fed liver, organs, bone marrow, brain, and more, all in the convenience of a capsule. For more information or to buy any of their products, go to ancestralsupplements.com. This episode is brought to you by Ample. Ample is a meal in a bottle that takes a total of 2 minutes to prepare, consume, and clean up. It provides a balance of fat, protein, and carbs, plus all the vitamins and minerals you need in a single meal, all from a blend of natural ingredients. It's available in original, vegan, and keto versions, portioned as either 400 or 600 calories per meal. I'm an advisor to Ample, and I use it to save time when I'm working on major projects on a tight schedule. It keeps my brain going while I power through the day, never letting food prep get in the way of my productivity. Head to amplemeal.com and enter the promo code CHRIS15 at checkout for a 15% discount off your first order.
The audio of this episode was enhanced and post-processed by Bob Devodian of Torian Mixing. You can find more of his work at torianonlinemixing.com. For ad-free versions of these episodes with transcripts that you can read and getting early access to the episodes, often weeks or maybe even months ahead of time, you can sign up for the CMJ Masterpass at chrismasterjohnphd.com/masterpass and use the code LITE10 to get 10% lifetime discount. All right, I hope you found this useful. Signing off, this is Chris Masterjohn of chrismasterjohnphd.com. This has been Chris Masterjohn Lite, and I will see you in the next episode.